Hey everybody, we are celebrating this is World Disappear Fear Day concert. Actually, Disappear Fear Day is on Thursday, 2/18, the Chaim Day. Press that. We're doing a lot of things at the same time, but I'm really happy that we have a special guest today. Good. So thank you for tuning in. Thank you for going through this whole freaking pandemic with me. And I get so much love from you listening and watching and liking and loving and all the wonderful things that you say. Really glad that you're here from Germany, from Florida, from California, from Hawaii, from Leiden, from Floto, from Tel Aviv and all around Israel and from Dubai and all over Germany from Hof. And probably missing a lot of other important ones, but I apologize. So anyway, welcome, bienvenido. Like to wish Annalie a happy birthday tomorrow. This is going to be posted on YouTube in case you miss it on Facebook or you want to share it with a friend and you go, oh, it was on Facebook, but now it's not. It will be on my YouTube channel, which is disappear.video, I think. It's definitely Disappear Video, and if you look into the playlist for Terrific Tuesdays, you'll find it. So anyway, without further ado, I want you to subscribe because that way it becomes effective for both of us. Okay, so my special guest is CiNDY. Here she is.
Hi, everybody.
CiNDY and I started Disappear Fear on October 10th, 1987. And, October 9th, 1987. 10/9/87, right. And had a crazy first 7 years together until CiNDY said, why? I don't want to spend my whole life on the road. And settled down to raise a family with her husband. And also lived away, too. I've been living in Baltimore, and she has been living in Texas and then Seattle, and now she's back in Baltimore, so it's very happy that we can do some singing together. This is there's so many songs, by the way, too. I just want to say this. I know I'm supposed to get started singing, but there's so many songs that have been a big part of Disappear Fear history, and what Disappear Fear Day is all about is disappearing fear. And CiNDY was just like always so supportive of me and being who I was. And she, when I came out in my life to myself and to the world, she was just like, just be. Like, why can't you guys hold hands? Why can't you kiss? And I'm like, well, because... So it was like, she was so very, very supportive to my well-being and my spirit and my soul. And it made all the difference for me. And the mirror gets reflected all the time. So that's you. So let's do Gangsters of Love. Anyway, the reason I started saying that was because it was difficult to choose what songs we were going to do. But I wanted to sort of break it up a little bit and do some songs that have some special harmonies. Of course, I love Washington Works' song and Who's So Scared and Me Too and By My Silence, but we wanted to do some different songs. So here's some different songs. This is Gangsters of Love from the CD, C minor. No Bomb is Smart.
Possibility.
And the crowd goes mild.
Sorry.
That was a joke. Anyway, that was fun. Thank you. You know, I think that's a TV joke. It's an Atomba Speakers joke.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think it was in the... It might have been Brian Timms, I'm not sure. I was just going to give credit. I always thought it was very funny because everybody thinks you're going to say, and the crowd goes wild, but let me say the crowd goes mild. I think it's funny. That's why I got to really work on my comedian career. One day, I was walking, and I was in San Diego, and John Flynn was praying, and he was outside his hotel room door, and I was sitting in a chair, and I was supposed to be really in a rush going back downstairs to connect with Terry, because they were doing some contest down there, and she had entered my name and whatever. So we were having this moment, so he was praying, and I was just like, that's really beautiful. I said, say hello for me. And he said, okay. And then I went downstairs, and everyone's chanting my name. It was about a couple hundred people, I guess about 300 or 400 people. And I'm not kidding. It was at the International Folk Alliance in San Diego about 10 years ago. And actually more than that, about 15 years ago. And about 97 years ago. And and they were chanting my name because I had won this $10,000 Yamaha full sound system.
Cool.
So I guess John dials direct, John Flynn. I mean, that's what happened, basically. It was like anyway, it was a moment. But it's not really what was the inspiration for the song. The song is older than that. BYOG. And I came up with it because it was always like, again, like the crowd goes mild, the crowd goes wild. BYOG, BYOB, bring your own beer, bring your own God. And I thought that, well, we do bring our own God, whatever that is or isn't. So this is that. Seems like a silly thing to fight about, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody. I love the love. Thank you. Post. That's right. It's 8 o'clock out there. Well, more
well,
like
you
8,
can see 7. All these hearts coming.
The, yeah, you can see the hearts and the claps and everything. See?
I can't see the words, though.
But if you have it here, like I usually do, yeah. Like right where my face is, mm-hmm. It's really distracting because I'm like reading it and wanting to say hello to everybody. And thank you, Mr. Brody.
Yeah.
I think he sent some hearts there for you. Good. All right. So let's give Terry a chance to say hello.
Oh.
Is that cool?
Yeah, but I don't want to break up your rhythm.
We're good. I just thought because
we're sliding here somehow.
Yeah, I'm over. Okay. Right. And I'm move over.
Okay. I won't be long. Hi, everybody. So today is our special World Disappear Fear Day concert a little bit early. It's going to be on the 18th. I hope you'll join us. There's been some incredible response from around the world, people sending us what they do to disappear fear. We lost a champion of disappear fear. She worked her butt off around the world to end fear for so many people in so many ways, in disability activism, in union activism, in poverty issues. And I happened to be at the hospital that day with my own fears, worrying about my mother when we got word that we had lost Ann Feeney to COVID. So today, especially, I'm thinking about her. I'm not going to pitch any merch to you because I'm just going to tell you, please reach down deep inside of yourself, find out what it is that you're fighting to disappear fear and join us, post it, let us know, and let's work together to make this world a better place. In honor of Ann today, special love. Love you guys.
Amen. Amen. Yes, me too. So many cool Anne stories. So many breaking rules stories with Anne. Oh man. But I won't go there right now. So I'll have to read it in the book. Excited to do this song for you.
You guys sound great. Thank you.
So this is another God song. I don't know if he's listening or not, but because it must be painful. I'm working with a really awesome music guru. His name is Pete Strobel, and I'm really learning like volumes and volumes and oh my gosh, of dimensions of things I don't know about music and the world, but particularly as it applies to music. So I hope it's not too painful for you, Pete, to be watching me today and listening. Shout out to you and Amanda, too. We're doing a podcast, an underground Baltimore sort of unsung hero, song hero podcast in the future, so you can look for that. I'm also going to be doing a podcast with Francis, Reverend Francis Faden. And she's
Franio.
Did her dear sister's Flo's birthday a couple weeks ago, actually just about a week and a half ago, and that was really awesome. So another shout out to Flo for her birthday. Lots of birthdays in February. People are active in the spring. But anyway, so I'll be doing a podcast with her too. I don't know the name of it, but it's probably about miracles and metaphysical, wonderful things. Metaphysical, letting your metaphysical imagination loose. So this is Good Morning, This Is God. And this song started out with a conversation with a friend in Arizona, actually. And I was playing at a bar, a lesbian bar there. I think it was called Nobody's Biz. Nobody's biz, right? And so I was staying with the owner of the bar at her beautiful house, and we did an amazing hike at dawn up to whatever is the famous hike that you do there. I guess there are plenty, but Arizona is very awesome. It wasn't Sedona. That was too far away, but it was amazing, and I was so proud that I could do it. Felt great, especially when the sun rises and you're at the top. Anyway, so she was in a 12-step program, not drinking, and I said something about quitting, and that's really the only way you can quit is if you quit quitting, because you've quit. So, and that was about cigarettes, but it applies to so many things. This is Good Morning, This Is God. 1999, me too, CD. Cigarette, doesn't it? Just kidding, kidding, kidding,
kidding. No, don't go there.
So we have one more song for you, and thank you so much for being part of part of our lives. A special, huge, ginormous thank you to my Patreon family. And I'm so grateful, and I'm really grateful too. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And I'm so happy that CiNDY came today to sing with me and be here and all that stuff. And it's really fun. So let the love continue. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. I think we're in the age of Aquarius, actually. Aquarius. And that too. And
mid-morning snack of the age of Aquarius.
Yeah, I'd like to give a shout out to Vipka for helping so much and getting the word out with WDFD, World Disappear Fear Day. And we've got lots of stuff. Elka in Hof is able to inspire all these people to participate with it. We've got lots of things in different languages, lots of work from refugees and or new immigrants to Germany and to this country. And that makes such a big difference to me, because it seems like if you're born into freedom and you're born into all these luxury things that we as Americans have, or any, probably in Germany too, a sense of freedom, you don't appreciate it as much as I think sometimes is when you don't have it, and then you have it again. And I guess that's very obvious through COVID, because you were normally going anywhere we want to, and now you're going nowhere you want to. I mean, you know, you're set to a certain place, which is different than having the choice. So I guess we're getting a sense of things in a very limited way, but still can drive you crazy. So hang in there. We're going to get through this. More and more people are getting vaccinated, and eventually you can get vaccinated too. So this is a song called Who I Am. Question that I'm constantly asking and answering for myself. And hopefully I'm coloring it in with the colors I want, of peace and gratitude instead of rage and anger. To all the people without power who probably aren't even seeing this right now. Millions and millions, I think 5 million Americans right now are without power because of the weather, snow. And this winter that I wrote this song, we didn't have any official heat either, and I really did move the heater from room to room to stay warm. Actually, it was very effective. Rather than heating, 20 rooms in a house, you heat the one you're in. Kind of smart, really. Perfume nearly everywhere. do it all. All dead and gone. Her children will rise. L'chaim, prost, disappear fear day, salud. I hope to see you again. Got live stuff on video Friday, and there's going to be all kinds of posts on WDFD, on the Facebook thing.
And YouTube.
And YouTube.
And subscribe.
Subscribe to YouTube, please.
Smack that button.
Thank you for smash that button. Thank you so much. Mwah. Love you, Ty.